Hello, my friend. I hope you're having a wonderful day. And if you watch my videos, you know I'm usually on an adventure in my F250 and four-wheel camper off-road home. But somehow I've acquired this crazy 6x6 vehicle behind me. Yes, it is a 6x6, which means it's six-wheel drive. Who needs four-wheel when you can get six-wheel? It has another set of wheels with an optional snow track set, and it triples as a boat. I can take this into the water, which makes it perfect for some fishing. But before I get into more about this crazy vehicle that I've somehow acquired, I have to test it out and see if it even works. And the way that I test all my vehicles is the donut test. What better way? So let's check it out and see how it does. Yep, it worked. Well, that was fun, and she definitely works. She passed the donut test. I use that anytime I purchase a used vehicle. So I roll up to the dealership, I jump into the car with the dealer. He's talking about all the options and the upgrades, and I'm like, I'm not worried about it. And I'm like, buckle up. And then I put my pedal to the metal, I burn some rubber, do some donuts, he pees his pants, and I'm like, I'll take it. Works perfectly. Don't worry though, I'm gonna do a lot more driving, take you on a whole bunch more terrain, more testing. But first, let's talk about some of these specs and how I acquired this 6x6 vehicle. Okay, so let's start front to back. First is this winch. I have a 2,000-pound worn winch on the front. The previous owner didn't have it hooked up, not quite sure why. We have to figure out what the issue there is. I always talked about needing a winch on my truck. I finally got one. Moving on, I have a removable windshield with a removable top, which covers the roll cage. I'm really excited about the cover that's removable. That was one of the reasons why I purchased it. For the wintertime, it's going to be great because it's going to keep me nice and cozy and warm when I'm plowing through the snow with my tracks on. Maybe I'll put a little buddy heater inside. Maybe that's not a good idea. Removable cover, removable windshield, roll cage. I also have two front headlights. Unfortunately, I only have one that actively works, so I'm gonna have to switch one out. So let's move down to the wheels. This is a 6x6 with three wheels on each side. What's cool is every single wheel is a drive wheel. They're driven by chain. These are 26x12-inch tires. They're great for mud driving. They're great for going into rivers and lakes because, yes, remember, this will go into the water. But what's also cool is it comes with another set of tires. They're a little bit lower profile, and you deflate them, and you can put these tracks on there, so it's perfect for plowing through the snow. So let's move around to the back end, which is where all the magic happens. I have a 25-horsepower, super powerful Kohler engine with a T20 transmission. I was actually up late last night watching some guy rebuild this transmission. It's amazing what you can find when you fall down the YouTube rabbit hole. It certainly needs some maintenance and some tune-ups before I take it on any serious adventures. I have to change the transmission fluid, the oil, check the belts, check the chain tensioners. My main problem though is getting this thing started from a cold start. I'm pretty sure it has something to do with a missing choke cable, because if you look here, there is a heated throttle cable, which is really cool because that means it'll help prevent it getting stuck when I'm out in the snow and it won't freeze. But then there's this random cable. I'm not really sure what it does. I thought it was the choke cable, but it doesn't move anything. It's actually attached to the same thing that the throttle cable is attached to, so I thought maybe it helps prevent it from getting stuck. I'm gonna give you a closer look, but this is way above my knowledge level. I know nothing about this. If you know anything about the choke cable, let me know where I should have it hooked up, because that's the main problem, getting it started. This is the throttle cable right here. This is the cable. I'm not sure what it does. It actually goes up to a little push-pull button on the dash up front, but when I push and pull, it doesn't do anything. It doesn't move anything at all back here. And then right below it, there's two holes that you can see, but it actually has three holes. It's what I've had to mess with to get the engine started now, and I'm thinking that might be where I need to hook up the choke cable. But I'm really not sure, so if you've worked on small engines, please let me know if this is where you would hook up the choke cable and what this cable is. So I have the engine cover on. It's pretty easy to take on and off. There is a small platform up here I could strap some equipment to, but I really want to build another rack over it so I can put even more on top of it. In order to get this to be a boat to float, there's two things I have to do. The first thing is I have to get some boat plugs for the bottom. They're not standard because I don't want them getting caught on anything and ripping out and then sinking. So two boat plugs down here. I have to find the right size. And then let me show you up front what I have to do up front to make this boat worthy.
There are two cracks that look like this. I'll either have to plastic weld them or use some of that infomercial flex seal.
Let me give you a quick look inside and how to drive this thing. So on the left here, we have the missing choke cable spot. Not sure what happened there. There's a 12 volt outlet. There's this random pole that I was talking about that's attached to that random cable in the back. When I pull on it, it does nothing. So let me know what you think it is. The brakes down here also serves as the emergency brake. There's forward, neutral, and reverse. And then we have the throttle and the steering. There's no steering wheel in this bad boy. Basically, you pull down on the throttle here and it'll start moving you forward straight. If you want to turn, you just pull on the left or the right lever. The further you pull, the harder that side will brake. So if I wanted to just turn slightly to the left, I would hold down the throttle and pull lightly on the left lever. If I wanted to do a hard left, I would pull it all the way back and it basically breaks the entire left side, and then you just continue to do donuts if you're holding the throttle. It's really bizarre driving something with no steering wheel. I've never driven anything like this, but it's incredibly fun. It's almost too much fun. In the back is where I'm going to keep all of my camping and fishing gear, and I think that's about it. That wraps up my boring tour. So let's go ahead and get going and take this for a quick spin. So jump inside and let's go. Exciting. I almost flipped this thing like three times, but it's getting dark. I think it's about time to start setting up camp.